It was a very good discussion regarding healthcare, labeling to 2-star, 3-star, 5-star, everything. NABH is done by the government of India. Can all eminent panelists, I've been following everybody, you are gems in the NABH and, all the guidelines. Can anyone show me one single hospital or healthcare setup run by government in tier 2 or tier 3? Have they taken any kind of initiative of even applying or impaling, the small steps what they are telling others to do that? Are we not pressurizing only the healthcare industry which is run by the other people to, you have to do this, you have to do this? If you just enter AIIMS, it is a chaotic. When they are not doing anything, first thing is, the first step should start from there. All we are talking about, the people who are insured, all insurance companies. But who is talking about the people who are at a very low level, who come from villages? That's a very big amount of patients which we are there. And that is the reason, all the poor people, they have to sell their lands, everything, because they don't have any kind of faith on a government-run hospital.
I would like Dr. Rana to answer this.
I think it's a very, very tricky question, having so many things inbuilt. But I think you're right. But we also need to understand one thing is, it's not possible for any government or any community for the matter to provide everything to everyone. That's the real matter of fact. But if you look at the recent Allahabad High Court order in UP, that they have said that no government official will take treatment in a private hospital.
Absolutely.
They have to go to the government hospitals.
Yes.
And that they directed the government of UP that you fill all the posts, vacant posts in the government hospital at all level. So they need not to go anywhere else and they get the treatment there. So I think that's a good move from the public management system that yes, you have facilities, because if you just say you just go to the government hospital, don't go to private, but do you have the facility and the, the managing things in government hospital, you don't have. So they have done second step as well that please prepare yourself with infrastructure, manpower, equipment to provide the care which we'll be requiring in time to come. So I think that's the thing. But I will go into the next level of that. Is we were talking about some of the colleagues here and in the audience that the tier 2, tier 3 cities is very difficult to say. I said the village, I come from a village. And then if someone fell sick, then he has to go to the nearest possible place. And if he or she can get the treatment, it's fine. Otherwise, God save some. So I think we have not reached that level. And that's what the role of primary, the government, where primary health centers were set up. But they are not functioning as they should be, have been functioning. So we fail in there. But I think now, again, a wave has started that we need to set up the primary health centers and small clinics are being set up. So things are moving and I think we should be hoping for the best. And different organizations are coming together to work together to create we are starting another accreditation body 6 months ago, developing different programs. And he's starting a new company to provide the care to the people who are traveling from village to the city. Similarly, these people are providing different. So I think if we come together in a network motion, I think we can make something better than what we have yesterday. Thank you.
Want to answer that, Dr. Ashwini?
Yeah, I would like to share one small Japanese philosophy here. If somebody has to do it, why not me? This is in exact contrast to what we have just expressed. And I firmly believe in this philosophy. Every small thing needn't be done by others always. Let's start with ourselves. Sorry.
Right, definitely. Excellent. Yes, definitely. 10 years back when we were talking about NABH, even I'm also a planner of hospitals and everything. So my only concern was like the government should take the first initiative of even basically, doing the PHCs where the patient can be stabilized and, again send it to the tier 2 or tier 3 city, tier 1 city.
Just to also bring to light, if you have read about this Ayushman Bharat program, which is launched in this budget by this government, where the two key initiatives government has taken. One is to cover about 10 crore of population of give them a 5 lakh of coverage, insurance, health insurance coverage. Second is setting up 1,50,000 wellness centers at the sub-center level to strengthen the primary health care. So one is making it affordable for tier 2, tier 3 villagers and the BOP population, about 50 crore people, that is 10 crore families. And second is 1,50,000 centers at the primary level. So probably that is one of the, maybe it's just the beginning.
We'll take more questions offline, please. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks to all the panelists and for the wonderful audience.
Thank you so much, all the participants. Thank you so much for this wonderful session. Now I would like to request Mr. Afzal Kamal, who is the editor and founder of MedGate Today and Voice of Healthcare, as well as I would like to request Mr. Manish Rastogi, please come on the stage to hand over the certificates of appreciation. Mrs. Rama Venugopal. Give a round of applause. Next is Mr. Swadeep Srivastav. Dr. B. K. Rana. Dr. Naveen Sharma. Dr. Naveen Sharma.
It's okay, you've been there in the system for too long.
Rahul Rao. Mr. Santosh.
Please, Dr. Santosh.
I don't know. I have
okay,
been Ashwini.
Dr. Ashwini Ookalkar.
Okay. Dr. Ashwini Ookalkar.
Dr. Garima.
Dr. Garima.
Ms. Garima.
Okay. Ms. Garima Trivedi. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, the next you can just summarize the